事嘛，我几句话补充，然后给大家来一个问答时间
啊。I'd like to add a few more words to what I explained concerning the seven, the first four seals and the first four horses. Before we ask you to put forward your questions.
我要强调的就是说，这个四马不是一批出来一批消失，是一批出来一批出来，四马并存
啊。I'd like to emphasize again that the appearance of the four horses is not one after another.But then they can appear at the same time.
而这个马是遍地走来走去，就是说，奉神的命令到处去执行他的工作。
And that these horses run to and fro throughout the earth, and by the command of the Lord, they are sent forth to do what the Lord bids them to do.
而这个都是象征性的。
And all these are, symbolic.
不是说白马在中国就不在美国了，不是。
It doesn't mean that.Once the horse is in China, then it will not be in U.S.
它可以同时在很多地方。
At the same time, it can be in the all nations of the world or many nations of the world.
因为这是一个象征性的工作。
Because the work, the horses is figurative of its work.
也就是说，
it does.
可以同时在好几个地方执行工作。
Because at the same time.It can be doing work in many, many places.
那至于灰马就是死亡。
As far as pale horse is death.
为什么神派灰马去执行这种工作呢？
Why does the Lord allow this pale horse to go and do his work?
现在我们请看以赛亚书十三章十一节。
Isaiah chapter 13 verse 11.
以赛亚书十三章十一节。
Isaiah chapter 13 verse 11.
我必因邪恶刑罚世界，因罪孽刑罚恶人，使骄傲人的狂傲止息，制服强暴人的狂傲。这里呀，神就是说，因为世界犯罪，所以我要刑罚世界。
And here the Lord says, I will punish the world for its evil.
我要刑罚恶人。
And will punish the wicked.
因为这个世界有罪
，because this world has sin，
所以神透过这几匹马去刑罚那些有罪的人。
So the Lord will punish the world through the work of these four horses。
我们知道人的灾难有很多原因。
We know that disaster come upon man for many reasons。
好像因为有人饮食不注意，所以生病了。
Sometimes because we are not careful about our food, we fall sick.
但是有些病是从魔鬼来的。
But then some sicknesses come from the devils.
好像约伯无缘无故生病。
Like Job, all of a sudden he fell ill.
因为神容许撒旦去加害他。
Because the Lord allowed the devils to attack him.
有些病是神直接降下来的。
But then there are some sicknesses that are the caused by direct intervention of God.
好像大卫犯罪。
Just like David sinned against the Lord.
大卫犯罪，神给他三个选择。
And the Lord allowed David to choose three punishment, three types of punishment.
三天的瘟疫呢
？Whether you want 3 days of pestilence?
还是被仇敌追赶三个月呢
？Or you will be pursued by the enemies for 3 months?
还是三年的饥荒呢
？Or you have 3 years of famine?
大卫说：“我情愿落在神的手中啊。”
David say, I choose to be stricken by the hand of the Lord.
所以国中三天瘟疫。
And so therefore he endured 3 days of pestilence.
一下子死了好多人。
And all of a sudden many people died.
所以很多病很多灾难是从神来的。
So many sicknesses, many calamities come directly by the intervention of God.
神可以直接降下灾难。
The Lord can send such calamity directly upon the world.
神可以允许撒旦去做作怪。
And sometimes the Lord can also permit Satan to do his work.
有些是自己不谨慎。
Some is because we ourselves are not watchful.
那这四匹马既然是神差派的。
Since these four horses were commanded to do this work by the Lord.
就是神看世界的局势，派四匹马去做他的工作。
So according to the conditions of the various places, God sent these four horses to the various nations to do his work.
所以白马可以同时在很多国家兴旺福音。
So therefore, the white horse can be in the nations of the world in many places to prosper the work of the gospel.
灰马也可以在很多时间同时杀人。
And the pale horse can be in many, many places, simultaneously killing people.
好，这个是我对这个四马的看法。
And this is my concept of the concept of understanding of the four horses.
而且刚刚我说的这个四马是前四印，也就是一七之前。
And these four horses belong, were seen when the four seals, first four seals were opened, and they belong to the time of the front period, or first half of the final seven weeks in Daniel.
我们看这个圣经的预言，很多精彩的事迹啊，都发生在最后的一期。
And the major events in the Bible, were before the world in the final seven, final seven weeks in the book of Daniel.
这个最后的一期又是一期之前跟一期之半。
And the final seven weeks can be divided into two sections, the first half of the final seven weeks and the second half of the final seven weeks.
圣经很多难解的问题都是在一期之半。
And the many, many areas where it's difficult to explain the Bible falls into this period of time.
但以理书用一期之半。
And the first, in the book of Daniel records the first half of the seven weeks.
启示录用42个月。
And Daniel talks about, I mean, so Revelation talks about 42 months.
用三年半。
Three and a half years.
用1260天。
And talks about 1260 days.
其实这四个都一样。
But in actuality, all these are the same.
三年半。
Three and a half years.
42个月。
42 months.
1260天。
1260 days.
一期之半都是一样的。
Or the first half of the final week.All these are referring to the same period of time.
所以在启示录里面，很多都发生在这一段期间。
And many events in the book of Revelation falls, will happen during this period of time.
所以我个人认为，这个四马都已经出来了。
So I personally reckon that these four horses have all appeared.
已经并存在世界啊，奉行了差遣。
Found all over the world in different countries.
有关这个四马的看法，我刚才用三个方向来解释。
So I've explained the four horses in the three different concepts.
好的，我们现在用一点时间呢，给大家发表一下，你们有其他的看法，请发表啊。
And now I will give you some time to express how you feel and what you think of these four horses.
因为我们这么多人呢，一定还有更好的看法。
We have so many people. Definitely, we have different views.
或者是对刚才讲的还不太明白，也可以发问啊。
好 ，If you have heard andNot fully understand, maybe you can ask again.
来，我们开始。刚刚那两个有在哈，那两个麦克风。
Is the wireless mic around?
好，哎，有谁要讲吗？要问吗？不要客气哦。不是了，给你讲，你要讲吗？我是说，不是，我是说这个要拿给要讲话的人了。我这里已经有了。
Just put it there, yeah.
有没有？我们时间很宝贵哈，来。
有些外教会说，这个白马，头一个白马哈。是低耶稣了
对，
这个是外教会常常解析的，因为这个白马第六章的白马跟十九章的白马他们拿的武器是不同的，所以他们是说第六章的应该是魔鬼了出现，头一根马是魔鬼，但是我们的解析就好了，但是其他教会解析的就是坏了，
就是解释假基督假先知。甚至是敌基督者了。
对。So some other Christian denominations explain that these are the false prophets. The white horse is a false prophet, false Christ, and the antichrist. Very in contrast with our understanding this morning.
那么刚刚我用那个第二个宗教的立场讲，那个基督教就是包含刚刚陈传道讲的这个。
And so, the second concept which I explained just now, where we explain the white horses under the religious. Direction then this would cover the first horse.
有没有？
对 ，Alvin。Antichrist。Yeah。哦，他是说可以不可以解析外教会的看法吗？那个为什么他们说是头一个马是第耶稣？
因为他们认为基督教它是假基督教，所以也用白出现嘛。
And they reckon that the false Christian preachers also appear in the form of white, and that's just like true prophets.
因为将来有假基督、假先知出现，那这既然假基督、假先知，一定要像基督嘛。
Because there will be false Christ and false prophets.Even though they are false, but their appearance is just like Christ, so, just like the prophets. But it comes like white.
一下子用黑色的，大家啊，这个黑色的一定不是的，所以才用白色的出现。
So if these false prophets appear black, then straight away we can identify them. But their appearance is likened to a white horse.
他打着基督的名号，其实他没有得救。
But they use the name of Christ, but in actuality they do not.Preach salvation, neither are they saved.
而且啊，他所以这样主张的理由，因为四匹马都是坏的，他认为四匹马都是坏的。
And the explanation is this: that all these appearances of horses, all these horses are evil.
那为什么只有第一匹是好的呢？为什么只有第一批是好的，其他三批？你们教会的解释，只有第一批是好的，其他三批都是坏的。所以他们的看法认为啊，坏都是通通坏啊。
And they say that how is it that our two judges explain the first horse as good, the other three horses as bad? So that is not consistency. So they say that if you explain as bad, then all the four horses are bad.
可是我们认为啊，在撒迦利亚书里面好多匹马。中间那一批还是好的。
But in Zechariah, the book of Zechariah, there appeared many horses, but the one of them is good.
所以不见得都是不好了。
But it cannot be said that all the horses are evil.
因为神要结束世界，要拯救世人，也要有好的出现呢，让你去选择。
Because when the Lord saves the world, the Lord wants to deliver us from sin, then He will also allow.Good prophets to come, or the good things to come upon us, and it is our choice to choose what is good to be saved.
那么第一批白马，我们解释为假基督、假先知，或者是敌基督者我们教会比较不接受这样的看法。
And our church would not accept the explanation that it is the first appearance, the appearance of the first horse is referring to false Christ, false teachers, and antichrist.
而且我们认为跟十九章的白马是一样的。
And we reckon.That the appearance in chapter 6 of the white horse is the same white horse that appeared in chapter 19.
前后才一致的。
Then only is there consistency.
因为在解释圣经哈，不能这里白的是好的，那边白的又变成不好的。
We must have consistency, especially when we explain the same book. White horse in chapter 6 cannot be evil when chapter 19 knows it's very clear that it is a good.It is referring to the appearance of Christ.
就好像马太福音十三章的两只鸟哈。
Just like chapter 13, the birds that appear in the parable in Matthew chapter 13.
你不能第一只鸟指撒旦，那第二只鸟指圣灵，那这样就不对了。
You cannot say that the parable of the sower, the birds that appear, is referring to Satan, whereas the birds that appear in the tree, mustard tree.
所以我在我们教会以前
to Satan,
对马太十三章
referring to Christ.
那两只鸟啊，有两种看见，一种是第一只是撒旦，那第二只是圣灵。
And so there are the explanations, saying that the birds that ate the seed refers to Satan. The birds that make his nest in the mustard seed plant.Is the Holy Spirit.
但是、
this type of explanation,
经过我们大家讨论之后认为、这两只鸟是应该一样，因为在同一个比喻里面、主耶稣讲同一个比喻，不可能一只鸟好一只鸟不好，不可以这样解释。
Because the parable of the seed of the sower is one parable, so we cannot say that the birds that ate the seed from the pathway refers to Satan, and the birds that appear in the mustard seed in the tree, makes his nest in the tree, is the Holy Spirit. Now, that kind of explanation is not consistent, so through our truth research, we reject that kind of explanation.
当然了，十九章跟第六章的两只白马也是一样的道理。
So in the same principle, Revelation chapter 6, the white horse, and the Revelation chapter 19, the white horse, cannot be explained one as good, the other one as evil.
因为十九章的白马是基督，当然这个地方也是基督。
Because Revelation chapter 19 explains very clearly that it is good, it is Christ, then chapter 6 must also be good.
那么从这个四匹马有好有坏哈，来证明神是慈爱的，也是公义的。
So from the appearance of the four horses, there are good, there are bad things. It means that God is merciful and loving.
啊，还有吗？有没有要发表新的看法？
Yeah, 各位， yeah.
来那个麦克风。
I have a question here. It relates to verse 6. It says, and I heard a voice. Whose voice is that? And the latter part of verse 6, do not harm the oil and the wine. This is from the voice who says, do not harm the oil and the wine. Who are the oil and who are the wine? And who said, do not harm?
他说第六章第六节，他听到声音，这个声音是属于谁的？
哪一个？第六
第六章第六节。
哦，是从神而来的启示了。
That voice is a revelation from God。
哦，神告诉他的。
这样不要伤害那个油跟酒啊，是
一样的，就是整个都是神的启示。
这个油跟酒是什么意思？
这个哈，这个。有的人呢，把它灵异解释了。
Some people will explain in the spiritual sense.
这个时候就油是指圣灵，酒是指真理的。
Some people say the oil refers to the Holy Spirit, the wine refers to the truth.
如果你要用灵异解释
，If you explain it in the spiritual sense,
那全部都要灵异解释。
Then everything has to explain in the spiritual
sense. 我现在是根据实际来解释。
Now I'm explaining in the materialistic form or practical form.
我不用灵异解释。
I do not explain in the spiritual.
我认为油就是我们使用的油，酒就是粮食。
And so oil, I will understand as the fuel oil that we use. The wine would refer to the food and the drink that.
所以将来的战争也可以说是能源战争，也可以说是粮食之战。
And so the war in the future will concern these things.
因为这里都在讲这个买卖天平啊。
Concerning the shortage of food and so on, and also of the power fuel, this oil. Yes.
在讲的时候提到了撒迦利亚书那边的十一节，那边有提到那个马。逃完之后就讲那个地健全地的安息平静，那个是什么意思啊？
撒迦利亚书第
11 verse 11 the last portion mentioned。
我说撒迦利亚书第一章十一节。
我知道了，因为撒迦利亚书第一章啊，跟第六章啊，好几匹马出现，那另外有当时的波斯的马代的巴比伦的，那个我们研究撒迦利亚再讲好吗？
The appearance of horses in Zechariah has something to do with the rebuilding of the temple, right? The time of rebuilding the temple, and those would have to go back to the background of Persia, and all those countries, Media and Persia. So it's a different thing altogether. If we explain it, then it's.
就是简单的说，就神兴起以前的帝国，像亚述、巴比伦、波斯、马代、希腊，
because
一匹马去
Zechariah,
去管理。
Would be the horses there would refer to how the Lord administers the establishment of nations like Assyria, of Roman Empire or Persia.And so on. That was during the rebuilding of the temple.
我们启示录结束以后哈， 各位如果还有兴趣，我们再来研究小先知书了，好吗？
After we have studied the book of Revelation, perhaps we have to go on to the, if we have interested to the study of minor prophets.
麦克风，这边，姐妹。
There's another microphone there. Yes.
谢谢啊。
My question concerns the different creatures. There are four living creatures, and each one announces the opening of the four seals. Is there significance in this? And does the sequence of the four creatures follow the sequence of the lion, eagle, and so forth in the earlier part of chapter 4?
他说说这个印打开的时候，是不同的四佛五宣布了。这个有什么意义呢？因为头一个音是第一个，
四马打开都是四活物在宣告哈，在配合。
When the four seals were opened, they announced, it was the living creatures who made the announcements.
那么黄长老解释啊，这个四活物就是完全的圣徒嘛。
And, Elder Elisha Huang explained these four living creatures as the perfect believers.
那所以啊，将来这个神的奥秘出现，就是让这些教会的完美的圣徒先了解。
So when the mysteries of God's word are revealed in the future, it is first revealed to the spiritual and perfect believers in the church.
因就是因为这些圣徒比较有关心这个圣经呐、世界的局势的。
Because these saints in the church are those who are concerned about them, the affairs of the church,
所以啊,
and also the current affairs in the world.
他们一定会先知道, 先明了。
So they would be the ones to have such revelation first.
就好像约翰大哭, 因为他需要明了。
Just like Elder John wept because he wanted to understand.
所以主耶稣就差遣长老安慰他说有人了，有人可以打开了。
So that was why the Lord sent the elders to comfort him, saying that there would be a one to open the seal.
越关心的人会越了解。
So the more you are concerned, the more you will understand.
越先了解了。
They will understand first.
那为什么用四个不同的这个活物来宣告？
Why was it that the each and every seal when it's opened is a different living creature that announces.
就让我们知道神对这个启示的部分常常是分别启示。
Meaning to say, when the mysteries of God are revealed, is revealed to different people from different sectors.
所以你看我们的传道人不能一个人圣经都明白不可能。
So amongst the preachers, it is not possible that one fully know all the mysteries in the Bible.
有些人对预言书比较了解。
Some have a deeper understanding, a profound understanding of the books of prophecy.
有些传道对四福音很有心得。
But then there are some who have very, very great understanding of the Gospels.
或者是摩西五经，他很有研究。
Or there are some who have research into the Pentateuch of Moses.
那你有研究，你就会先发表，好像四活物先讲出来了。
Then you have studied into it, so you will be the one to express what your study into books. So you are like the living creature to announce it.
因为也只是恩赐不同。
And because the gifts are different.
我们要尊重这些有恩赐的人。
So we have to respect these people for their gifts.
一面也告诉我们四活物是首先了解世界局况的。
And also we can know that it is the four living creatures who would know the mysteries and the current affairs very clearly first.
虽然一个活物宣告一项。
Although it was one living creature each that announced that the opening of the seal.
还是让我们知道世界的最重大的事件还是四活物先宣告的。
But it also tells us that the major events in the current affairs of the world or in world history are no make known to these living creatures.
所以黄长老他对这个解释是说，完全的属灵人才能够看透属灵的事。
And the perfect spiritual believers are able to discern spiritual things.
也才能够宣讲属灵的事。
And only they can announce and proclaim spiritual matters.
我想应该是这样的含义吧。
I believe this is the meaning and explanation.
好了，我们今天呢要准备要把第六章解释完哈，所以我看还是到这里了哈。以后我还找时间呢再给各位发问哈。
We try to cover chapter 6 today.
因为我们恐怕讲不完了。
I'm very concerned that we won't be able to finish our.
我们这一次啊预定到十一章了哈，十一章。
On this occasion, we will only finish up to chapter 11 in our study of Revelation.
下半段呢、啊，我们明年的时间呢、啊，再跟负责人再敲定哈、啊，什么时候哈、
啊。The second half of Revelation, we will find a suitable time next year, to conduct this study.
好，现在看第六章第九节开第六第五印。
Chapter 6, verse 9, when the fifth seal was opened.
揭开第五印的时候
When the fifth seal was opened,
我看见在祭坛底下有为神的道并为做见证被杀之人的灵魂
I saw under the altar the souls of those who have been slain for the word of God for the testimony which they held.
第十节
Verse 10,
大声喊着说圣洁真实的主啊你不审判住在地上的人给我们生流血的冤要到几时呢
And they cried with a loud voice saying How long, O Lord, holy and true Until you judge and avenge our blood on those who dwell on the earth
十一节
Verse 11
于是有白衣赐给他们个人
And a white robe was given to each of them
又有话对他们说
And it was said to them
还要安息片时等着一同做仆人的和他们的弟兄也向他们被杀满足了数目
That they should rest a little while longer until both the number of the fellow servants and the brethren who will be killed as they were was completed
好这个第五印简单的说就是教会受大逼迫开始
And in simple words when the fifth seal was opened would be the period when the true church would be greatly persecuted
那这个也是进入一期之半
And this would be in the first half of the final 7 weeks in the book of Daniel
也是最后的42个月了
And this would be the final 42 weeks in the book of Daniel
我们先看
42 weeks in the book of Daniel
先看这个启示录十一章
We turn to Revelation chapter 11
启示录十一章的第三节说两个见证人穿毛衣传福音1260天
Sorry, it's 42 months in chapter 11
十一章第三节
Verse 3, chapter 11 verse 3 And I will give power to my two witnesses and they will prophesy 1260 days
好那么做完见证的时候第七节他们做完见证的时候从无底坑上来的兽与他们征战并且得胜把他们杀了
Verse 11 When they finish their testimonies the beast that ascends out of the bottomless pit will make war against them overcome them and kill them
所以无底坑上来的兽就是撒旦要逼迫这个两个见证人就是在1260天的见证之后
So the beast that appears out of the bottomless pit is Satan, and they will make war against those who proclaim the gospel during this period of 1260 days.
好，那么我个人呢、啊，认为这个第五印就是教会全面的受大逼迫了。
So I reckon that the fifth seal would cover the period when the whole church will be greatly persecuted.
那这个呢，还没有开。
And this fifth seal had not been opened.
如果第五印一开了，我们现在不是这么平安了。
When the fifth seal is open, we will not be as peaceful as now.
也许我们聚会啦、灵恩会啦，都要偷偷的啦。
Maybe we have to conduct our spiritual meetings and services in secret.
甚至我们常常听到昨天哪一个弟兄被抓了，哪一个姐妹被杀了，都说不定的。
We will hear.That oh such a such brother has been taken by the authorities or such a brother such a sister have been killed for the gospel.
所以当第五印一开的时候
，When the fifth seal was opened，
在祭坛底下有那些为神的道、为给耶稣做见证人被杀的灵魂呐、
啊。I saw under the altar the souls of those who have been slain for the word of God for the testimony which they held.
这些被杀的人就是为主殉道、殉身。
Those who have been killed were those who were martyred for the word of God.
这是第五印开始。
This was the fifth seal.
所以我们现在在培养信心。
So now we nurture our faith.
目的就是要应付开第五印的时候。
And the purpose is to strengthen ourselves in readiness for the fifth seal when it is opened.
因为我们的信心如果不刚强啊，第五印一打开啊，可能很多人都跌倒了。
If our faith is not strong, by the time the fifth seal is opened, many would fall.
第十节说，那些灵魂啊，被杀的灵魂啊，在呼冤呢。
And verse 10 says, they cried with a loud voice. The souls of those who have been slain were cried with a loud voice.
说神啊，你不替我们伸冤吗？ 你要到什么时候呢？
How long, O Lord, until you judge and avenge our blood on those who dwell on the earth?
住在地上的人不是信徒，是指那些没有信的人。
Those who dwell on the earth are not the believers, but unbelievers.
我们是住天上的人，我们是属天上的人。
We belong to the heavens above.
所以这个地上的人是属于地的，属于世界，属于撒旦的。
Those who dwell on the earth are of Satan and of the world.
那就是那些属撒旦、属地的人在逼迫我们呢。And
those of Satan, those of the world, would persecute us.
那么他们被杀之后，就在那边伸冤呐，神呐，求你给我们伸冤吧。
So those who were slain were ask the Lord to vindicate them.
你到底要等到什么时候呢？
How long, O Lord, will you wait?
11节啊。
Verse 11.
这个时候有一件白衣赐给他们。
Then a white robe was given to each of them.
然后对他们说，再安息一下下。
And it was said to them that they should rest a little while longer.
你们再等一下。
Wait a longer, little while longer.
等到被杀的数目满足了。
Until both the number of their fellow servants and their brethren who would be killed as they were was completed.
所以这个大逼迫有一段期间。
So in the great persecution, there will be a period of time.
这期间呢，有很多信徒被杀。
During this period of the great persecution, many brethren would be killed.
而且神已经定了一个数目。
And the Lord has fixed the number to be killed.
这个数目满了，逼迫就停止了。
And when this number is completed, then the persecution would cease.
所以这个要拉多长，多少人被杀，我们不知道。
How long that period of persecution would be, how many would be killed, we do not know.
不过先死的人啊，一定要等了。
But those who are killed first will have to wait.
到了16章，那边呢，神就伸冤了。
In chapter 16, the Lord vindicated these people.
16章的第三晚，到第三晚的时候，就是替他们伸冤了。
When the third bowl was put down, that would be the period of the vindication of those people who were slain for the world.
那个时候就是数目满了。
And that would be the time when the number of people killed is completed.
所以我们看回来，到底这个数目有多少，我们不知道。
And so when we read chapter 5, we do not know how many will be killed.
我们大家是不是有人要去填满那个数目？
Amongst us would be those who have to fill up this number.
如果真的我们当中啊要去填这个数目的话，我想哈，你们机会比我大。
I believe that if there should be amongst us those people who will be killed for the work of the gospel, the chances of you being killed is more than high.
因为这个第五印还没有开啊。
Because the fifth seal had not been opened.
所以越年轻的机会越大啊。 So
the younger you are, the more likely you will be amongst those number to be killed.
所以啊，年轻人啊，更要赶快培养信心。
So the younger people should cultivate their first faith quickly.
才能够像但以理啊，面对狮子坑我不怕。
Then only can you be Daniel, who would not be afraid even when thrown into the den of the lions.
丢就丢嘛。
You want to throw me into the den?
如果在现在你要丢狮子坑啊，你会考虑哦。 我宁可否认耶稣比较好。
If now you are to be cast into the lions, then many of us will choose to deny Christ.
像但以理的三个朋友，
just like the three friends of Daniel,
丢到火窑里面去。
When they were thrown into the fiery furnace,
对王说，我们不拜你的像啊。
He says, I will not worship your idols, they said to the king.
神会救我们啊。
The Lord will deliver us.
就算神不救我们也不拜了。
Even if the Lord does not deliver us, we will not worship you.
那种信心,
the golden image.
那种信心读起来很快啊, 你要做不简单耶。
That kind of faith is very, very joyous to read, but it's not easy to do.
所以现在, 我们就是在培养啊, 应付这个大逼迫的时候。
So now is the time for us to nurture ourselves so that we can face this great persecution to come.
你看使徒行传啊, 从第七章开始, 斯提凡被逼迫。
In Acts chapter, in the book of Acts, from chapter 7 onwards, Stephen was persecuted.
然后第八章啊, 耶路撒冷全面受逼迫。
In chapter 8, the whole church of Jerusalem was greatly persecuted.
所以门徒在往外逃。
Then the believers were scattered.
这个是逼迫的一个比较全面厉害的。
And that was when the church was greatly persecuted.
那么到了罗马帝国的时代。
But in the period of the Roman Empire.
还有天主教的时代。
In the period of the Holy Roman Empire.
对基督徒的逼迫又是很厉害。
And the persecutions upon the Christians were even more severe.
所以现在你到意大利到罗马去参观了，有那个竞技场都是在刑罚基督徒的。
Now, if you were to go to Rome,you will find the Colosseum there where they persecuted and killed many Christians.
到了第二次世界大战
In the Second World War,
德国苏联逼迫犹太人
the Germany and Russia persecuted the Jews.
也是死了几百万
And a few million of the Jews were killed.
我曾经到德国去参观
And I've been to Germany.
看那个刑罚犹太人的这个那个刑场啊
to look at the place, to visit to the place where many of the Jews were slain.
有的是放瓦斯的
瓦斯
gas, yes.
They were gassed to death.
有的是用吊的
and some of them were hung to death.
什么刑罚都有
all types of punishment.
有的一整批啊进去，然后瓦斯一开，通通完了。
A whole group of them were put into the gas chamber, and they just turned on the gas, and all of them died.
再看近代，1949年，中国逼迫基督徒。
In 1949, the communist China, communist government persecuted the Christians.
现在比较好了。
And now they are more relaxed.
那将来呢？这个敌基督的出现了以后。
Later on, when the Antichrist appear,
也就是十三章的两只兽出现
，and that is the two beasts in Revelation chapter 13,
就开始逼迫了
，and that will be the persecution.
所以第五印呢，就是教会全面受逼迫。
So in the fifth seal, when it was opened, we say that the church will be the period when the church is is widely persecuted.
好，那么现在有一个问题啊，就是六章第九节哈。
Now the Christian is in chapter 6 verse 9.
黄长老说这个祭坛呢，他认为是香坛。
And this altar here, Elder Elisha Wang recognized this as the altar of incense.
哦，那里有一个在祭坛底下呼喊嘛，哈，祭坛。
啊，祭坛。
祭坛。
啊 ，is the altar of sacrifice.
黄长老认为啊，因为这是在深渊在祷告，所以他认为是香坛。
Sorry, there are two altars on the tent of meeting or in the tent of meeting. One is the altar of sacrifice, the other one is the altar of incense. Altar of incense refers to prayer, and because this passage here talks about prayers, so Elder Elisha Wang interprets this altar as altar of incense.
啊，这个是会幕哈，会幕。
This is the tent of meeting.
祭坛在这里。
And the altar of sacrifice is that spot there.
啊，祭坛呢、啊，就是把牛羊啊拉到这里来杀了啊，在这里献。
That was the place where the bulls and the rams were slain and sacrificed.
那么我们中文呢、啊？哦，英文不知道哈、啊。中文是翻译做祭坛啊。
And the Chinese Bible has interpreted this verse as the altar of sacrifice.
这里呀、啊、是香坛。
And whereas the one inside the holy sanctuary is the altar of incense.
黄长老认为啊，他们是在呼喊，是在祷告，所以应该是香坛的。
And here he says that the saints have been crying to the Lord, those who were slain, so therefore praying to the Lord, therefore that altar should be the altar of incense. This was the understanding of Elder Elisha Huang.
其实哈，原文没有说香坛，也没有说祭坛，只有说。
But in the original text, there was no mention of altar of incense nor altar of sacrifice. Only the word altar was used.
那只有说坛啊，也可以说祭坛，也可以说香坛。
Since only the word altar was used, it can be used to explain the altar of incense or the altar of sacrifice.
那中文的圣经为什么翻祭坛？
Why does the Chinese Bible explains this altar as the altar of sacrifice?
那么关于这一点的看法，我跟黄章老师有一点不同了哈。
As far as this is concerned, I have a different viewpoint from Elder Elisha Huang.
我还是赞成祭坛的。
I still agree that this altar is the altar of sacrifice.
因为原文既然没有说是香坛，是祭坛啊。
Because in the original text, there's no mention whether this altar was of sacrifice or of instance.
黄长老的理由是因为在祷告，所以是香坛。
And the reason why Elder Elisha Huang explained as altar of incense because the people were praying, so therefore it refers to the altar of incense.
那为什么我赞成祭坛？
Why do I say it is the altar of sacrifice?
因为我是认为是在强调被杀。被杀的灵魂被杀。
I reckon that here talks about souls of those who have been slain, sacrificed.
那被杀一定是在祭坛，不可能在香坛。
Since they were sacrificed, therefore it must be in the altar of sacrifice.
那既然是被杀。
Since they were slain,
一定是祭坛。
It must be the altar of
sacrifice. 在这里被杀，同时在这里呼冤呢。
And since they were slain there, it was also there that they cried to the Lord to be vindicated.
我强调的是被杀，那么黄长老看的是呼叫。
So what I'm emphasizing is being slain, whereas Elder Elisha Huang emphasizes on crying to the Lord, praying to the Lord.
我没有说他错我对哦，我没有这样说。
I'm not saying that he is wrong, I'm right.
我是说我是这样的看法。
I say that my viewpoint is stressed on sacrifice.
因为我看的是被杀，那被杀这个地方既然杀在这边。被在这里被杀也可以在这里呼冤的。
And so, since they were sacrificed, I reckon that this altar is an altar of sacrifice, and it was there that they cried to the Lord to be vindicated.
就好像希伯来书的作者说，亚伯的血在地里向你呼叫，那就是亚伯被杀的地方啊，有血呼叫。所以什么地方被杀，什么地方就可以呼叫了。
In the book of Hebrews, it says that.Abel, the blood of Abel is speaking. That was Abel was stoned to death, and that was where the blood cried out.
因为原文只有坛啊坛，没有说什么坛。
The original text in verse chapter 6 verse 9 is only the altar.
英文怎么翻译？
就是坛。
坛啊，所以哈，因为是坛了，所以哈，哪个坛了？随便我们说了哈。那我的理由是被杀啊，他的理由是祷告啊，是这样子。
So this altar, I understand it as the altar of sacrifice, whereas Elder Elisha Huang understood as the altar of incense. The reason is because I deem that this was the altar where they were sacrificed.
所以简单的说哈，这个第五印呢，就是教会进入大逼迫。
So the fifth seal when it was opened.Will be the period of time when the church was widely persecuted.
还没有到。
Yet, this period had not come upon us.
就是将来有一天会到。
But one day in the future it will come.
所以我们可以感受得到。
So we can feel.
现在我们太自由啊。
Today we have so much freedom.
我们没有感觉到我们在受大逼迫啊。没有。
We do not feel that we are greatly persecuted.
可是有一天会来。
But the day will come.
就是大红龙出现的时候。
That is when the great dragon appears.
就是十二章的大红龙。
That great serpent dragon in chapter 12.
还有十三章的两只兽。
And the two beasts in Revelation chapter 13.
这些都是进入大逼迫了。
And that will be the period when we enter into the great persecution.
所以启示录的这个七号是到十一章哦，十二章以下都是补充说明。
And so the trumpet, the seventh trumpet ends in chapter 11, chapter 12 onwards.Supportive explanation of what has taken place.
好，现在我们进入第六印啊。
And now we go on to the sixth sealed.
六章十二节。
Chapter 6 verse 12.
揭开第六印的时候，我看见地大震动。
When I look when they opened the sixth seal, behold, there was a great earthquake.
日头变黑像毛布。
And the sun became black as sackcloth of hair.
满月变红像血。
And the moon became like blood.
天上的星辰坠落于地。
The stars of heaven fell to the earth.
如同无花果树被大风摇动落下未熟的果子一般。
As a fig tree drops in its late figs when it's shaken by a mighty wind.
好，天就挪移，好像书卷被卷起来。
Then the sky receded as a scroll when it is rolled up.
山林海岛都被迁移离开本位。
Every mountain and island was moved out of its place.
十五节。
Verse 15.
地上的君王、臣宰、将军、富户、壮士和一切被为奴的、自主的，都藏在山洞和岩石穴里。
And the kings of the earth, the great men, the rich men, the commanders, the mighty men, every slave and every free man hid themselves in the caves and in the rocks of the mountains.
16节啊，就向山和岩石说，倒在我们身上吧。
And said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne.
哦，把我们藏起来，躲避作宝作德的面目。
Falls on us and hides us from the face of him who sits on the throne.
还有羔羊的愤怒。
And from the wrath of the lamb.
因为他们愤怒的大日到了。
For the great day of his wrath has come.
谁能站得住呢？
Who is able to stand?
好，这个是第六印。
This was the opening of the sixth seal.
那么到底第六印是什么呢？
What does this mean?
你看黄长老这个解释哈。
If you read the explanation of Elder Elisha Huang,
他有两个猜测。
And he has two assumptions. He had two assumptions.
主耶稣再临。
First assumption was at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ.
一个是就是末日的末日。
And the last day.
所以才会觉得说神的大日到了。
And so he felt that the great and terrible day of the Lord had come.
基督再临末日是不是第六号呢？第六印呢？
Is the opening of the sixth seal the second coming of the Lord the last day?
我觉得不是的。
I feel that it is yet, it is not.
因为灾难太大了，以为是世界末日了。
Because the calamities are so great, it is as likened to the last day, the day of the Lord.
假如第六印是世界末日，那么第七印就不必开了。
If the sixth seal refers to the last day of the world, then the seventh seal need not be opened.
我想这是很简单的理由啊。
This is a very simple reason.
如果这是末日，那第七印可以停下来了，不必开了。
If this is the last day, then the seventh seal need not be opened.
所以我认为这是一个空前的大灾难。
And I feel that this is a calamity that had never happened before, but would happen at that time.
让全世界人都感觉到好像世界末日到了。
So that the whole world will think that that is the last day to come.
所以由内心发出来的恐惧。
And there will be great fear from within themselves.
那么第六印是什么？
What is that opening of the second seal?
不是基督再来。
It's not the second coming of the Lord.
不是世界末日。
It is not the last day of the world.
也不是世界大战。
It is not the great war of the world.
因为世界大战是在第七印的第六晚呐。
Because the world war, the great world war, is in the sixth bowl of the seven trumpet or seven seal.
那才是真的世界大战。
That is the great world war.
所以到底第六印是什么？
What is this sixth seal?
我们只能够说是空前的全世界的大灾难。
And we will say that this is the great calamity to fall upon the whole earth that had never happened in history of the world.
但是这个大灾难是什么？
What is this great calamity?
为什么全世界这么怕？
Why is it that the whole world is so frightful?
为什么山林海岛都迁移？
Why is it that mountains and the hills are all shifted?
为什么日月都变色？
Why is it the sun and the moon changes in color?
天上的星也坠落了。
And that the stars of heaven falls down.
其实我看这个第六印看了看了，我觉得很简单耶。
And I look at it, I feel that, it's so that simple.
因为主耶稣已经一开始就说明了。
Because Jesus Christ has said,
我们再看一下哈，
please read again.
十二节
，verse 12。
揭开第六印的时候，我又看见地大震动。
I looked when they opened the sixth seal, and behold, there was a great earthquake.
所以我个人很直觉的认为啊，第六印就是空前的大地震。
And so from this verse alone, I reckon that this is the great earthquake that would happen at that time, but had never happened.Before in the history of the world.
全世界齁，所有的灾难呢，是地震最可怕。
And among the calamities that are most frightful in the world is earthquake.
马来西亚有一团访问团到台湾去。
There was a tour group from our church to Taiwan.
说不定你们当中也有人参加，说不定。
Maybe some of you were in that tour group.
那一次应该是十年前吧。
That was 10 years ago.
刚好住在台北教会。
And they were staying in Taipei.
刚好来个地震，四级的地震。
And there was an earthquake measuring 4 on the Richter scale.
有一个50多岁的姐妹刚好爬到上面的床要睡觉。
And there was a 50-odd-year-old sister who climb up the upper deck of the double decker bed to sleep.
四级的地震来了，四级。It
was only a Richter earthquake of measuring 4 in the Richter scale that struck Taiwan.
921的地震是7.3呢。
But the earthquake on September 21, 1999 was 7.3 on the Richter scale.
每一级就像原子弹爆炸那么大。
And every measurement is equivalent to one atomic bomb being exploded. And the shaking is equivalent to the magnitude and damage of one atomic bomb.
那么姐妹跨上去要到顶上去睡觉，结果四级地震一来被震下来。
That sister on the upper deck, when the shaking began because of that earthquake, she was thrown out of bed.
震下来以后还在摇嘛。
And it was still shaking.
他就用爬的。
And so she kept on the floor.
一直 Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
She kept on shouting Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
停了以后，我刚好在外面呢。
And after the shaking stopped, I happened to be outside.
我说姐妹好不好？
I asked her sister, How are you?
哎呦，是不是耶稣来了？
I said, Is it that Jesus has come?
我说还没有。
I said, Not yet.
这是地震。
This is only an earthquake.
啊，有吓死人了！那以后我不要来台湾了。
It's so frightened. I will not want to come to Taiwan again.
我说才四级啊。
I say this is only measuring 4 on the Richter scale.
这种地震我们已经司空见惯了。
And we are so used to this type of small earthquakes.
为什么第六音一开，大家认为神的愤怒大日到了？
Why is it when the sixth seal was opened, everyone would think that the great day of wrath of the Lord had come.
是因为有一个空前的大地震发生。
Because this great earthquake had never happened in the history of the world before.
我们现在的地震是小了，很小。
Our earthquake now is of small scale.
可是七级以上就过吓人了。
But if the earthquake should measure 7 and above, it would be a major disaster.
4年前台湾的921大地震。
In the September 21st earthquake in Taiwan 4 years ago,
那些灾区大楼房是用倒的，这样倒，有的倒这样，有的倒那样。
In the area affected, the apartment buildings fell down one whole block sideways. Some fell in the front.
整排的这样倒啊。
One whole block of apartment fell down this way.
所以能够当时把它拍起来，就好像房子在跳舞，so
很美。 Take a photograph. It's just like the apartments doing the dance.
有的人是向前倒的。
And some fell in front.
有人向后倒。
Some fell backwards.
有的大楼是直接蹲下来，就坐下来，变10层，变4层，变2层。
Some just sank into the ground. The sixth floor became the second floor, or the eighth floor became the fourth floor.
这个大马路裂开，从中间裂开。
The road had cracks.
有的断掉。
And some were cut into two. Cut into two.
桥梁断了很多
，and the bridges were all damages.
国民小学哈，中学里面的操场凸起来
，and the field in the school hall became a hill.
那是足球场变成山了。
And that was a football field, but it became a hill.
我们有一个县哈，一块土地，从这个县移到那个县5公里。
There was in the county a piece of land shifted 5 kilometers away to a next county.
所以这里说山林海岛多千里，这个我相信。
So I believe that this mountain and the island was moved. I believe this is what happened.
那家人被移动5公里。
And that family's land was shifted 5 kilometers away.
那么在大地震一分多钟，这个大地震让它已经失去差不多失去知觉一样。
And during that period of more than a minute of shaking, it lost all its feelings.
等到醒过来，哎，
By the time he's awake.
怎么我们家怎么来一个池塘啊？哪里来的？
How is it suddenly we have a pond in front of our house?
5公里啊，已经转了。
The land had been shifted 5 kilometers away.
我家那棵大树哪里去了？
Where is that big tree in front of the house?
在5公里外找到。
And they found that tree 5 kilometers away.
我们有一个信徒住在2楼。
And one of our church members stayed in the second level of apartment building.
大地震的时候，赶快逃啊！
And by the time of the earthquake, they wanted to run.
他要从2楼逃到1楼出去。
Wanted to run down one floor and run out of the door.
到了楼梯找不到楼梯。
But when they came down, couldn't find that stair.
往窗外看，哎，马路就在窗外啊。
And on that second level, you saw that the road was
level. 原来啊，他的二楼已经蹲下来了。
The building had 15.
所以啊，直接从窗户出去外面。
So they could go out to the level of the road, just by the window.
刚好出去，房子整个垮下来。
And when as soon as they go out, went out of that building, the whole building collapsed.
大地震哦，任人非常可怕的。
It is so frightful when this great earthquake strikes.
所以这一辈子哈，大家经历过921大地震了，清清楚楚了。一谈到地震啊，小的都不怕了啦。
Those who have undergone that great earthquake on September the 21st are very, very a great experience, and they are no longer afraid of the smaller earthquakes, but
And
so this great earthquake in chapter 6 must be something that have never happened before.
我没有说绝后哦。
I do not say that it will not happen again in the future.
因为绝后是第七号的第七晚。
Because in chapters, in the teacher, seventh trumpet,
第七晚了，一到下来，全世界大地震。
In the seventh bowl, in the seventh trumpet, when the bowl is poured down, there will be great earthquake all over the world.
圣经说，自从有人以来，没有这样大的地震。
And the Bible says that this great earthquake, the magnitude has never been experienced by mankind before.
那就是空前绝后的了。
And that would be the final earthquake.
所以我认为第六印是空前的大地震。
And so, therefore, I say that chapter 6 would be the great earthquake.
现在我们看以赛亚书24章。
And now we turn to Isaiah chapter 24.
以赛亚书24章。
Isaiah chapter 24.
从十四节开始
，verse 14 onward，
十四节到二十节
，from verse 14 to 20，
这里在描述地震的可怕
，and here talks about how destructive earthquakes can be。
十八节说，躲避恐惧的坠入陷坑。
二十四章，
二十四章，
十四节，
十八节。
verse 18， here says he who flees from the noise of the fear。
他说，天上的窗户开了。地的根基也震动了。
The windows from on high are open, the foundation of the earth are shaken.
19节。
Verse 19.
地全然破坏，尽都崩裂，大大震动了。
The earth is violently broken, the earth is split open, the earth is shaken exceedingly.
20节。
Verse 20.
地要东倒西歪，好像醉酒的人，又要摇来摇去，好像吊床。
The earth shall reel.To and fro like a drunkard, it shall totter like heart. Its transgression shall be heavy upon it.
我在想，以赛亚先知啊，也一定经过大地震。
I believe that Isaiah must have experienced an earthquake before.
因为他描写的很真实啊，很逼真。
Because he was so apt, so correct in describing the damage of an earthquake.
那么大地震发生的时候
，when the great earthquake happens,
就日头变黑，满月变红。
Then the sun shall turn black, and the moon become like blood.
天上的星会坠落
，and the stars of heaven fall to the ground.
因为这个地震哦，会影响宇宙啊。
Because the earthquake will affect the stars and the weather.
比如说火山爆发
like for instance, when the volcano erupts.
或者是瓦斯爆炸。
So all the gas tank is exposed.
那满天都是黑云啊。
Then clouds would fill the sky.
当然了，日头就被遮起来了。
Then of course, the sun would not be seen.
如果地震在发生火灾的话。
When the earthquake happens and fire breaks out.
满月像红，像血。
Then the moon becomes like blood.
那有人研究这个科学是说。天上的万象影响地震啊，而有人说是因为地震影响天象。
Some people say that the movement of the stars will cause the earthquakes on Earth. Some people say that the happenings, the earthquakes on Earth will affect the weather, the stars.
那么这里讲的哈，因为大地震。
And here talks because of this earth, great earthquake.
日头变黑。
The sun becomes black.
满夜像血。
And the moon becomes black.
天上的星辰坠落。
The stars of heaven fall to the ground.
然后山林海岛都迁移。
And then every mountain and island would be moved out of its place.
然后全世界人去躲起来了。
And then the people of the world would hide themselves.
躲山洞，躲岩石。
Will hide themselves in the caves, in the rocks.
因为地震呢、啊，没地方躲了嘛。
Because of earthquake, they have no place to hide.
那现在我们要知道为什么会地震
？Why is there earthquake？
其实原因很多。
And there are many reasons.
科学家讲的原因太多了。
And according to scientists, there are so many explanations as to why earthquakes happen.
一般民间说啊，地牛啊，地牛在翻身了、
啊。And some people say 地牛。
地下有一条牛啊，那么承载太重了，所以它动一动了。
So the bull in the earth turns around、嗯。
那科学家说是火山爆发啦。
And so they say volcanic eruption、啊。
地层断裂啦。
Or cracks on the earth。
什么原因都有了。
They have many explanations。
但是圣经记载地震的唯一原因。
And but the Bible tells us the only reason for earthquakes。
请看耶利米书十章十节。
Jeremiah chapter 10 verse 10。
第十章第十节
Jeremiah 10 verse 10
为耶和华是真神是活神是永远的王他一发怒大地震动他一恼恨列国担当不起、哦、这里记载、啊、地震的唯一原因是神发怒
And the only reason explained in the Bible is that it's because the wrath of God that earth will tremble
是、啊、一发怒啊地就承担不起了、
and the nations will not be able to endure his indignation
那问题是神为什么会发怒
and the question is why is God angry
就是因为罪嘛
because of sin
所以人犯罪神发怒地大震动
so because man sin there's a wrath of God and the nations will the earth will tremble
那这个不违背科学哦
and this is not against scientific explanation
神发怒所以让他这个地层断裂
and so because of God's wrath there will be cracks on the earth
神发怒让他火山爆发
and because of God's anger the volcanoes erupt
这些都可以引起地震
and all this will cause earth tremble and earthquakes
所以啊第六印、哦、就是空前的大地震
and so therefore this great earthquake in chapter 6 seal is never happened before
日本的关西大地震
关西
关西大阪
in Osaka when the earthquake struck
已经十年前了
that was 10 years ago
当时啊地震专家这样说
And the people who study into these earthquakes explain.
这次的地震要恢复旧观，最少要十年。
For it to be restored to its original situation, it takes 10 years.
最少要花美金一千亿。
一千一百，一千 how many billion?
一千亿的。天文数字哈。
六千，啊 ，1,000 million 呢？
一千
hundred million billion hundred billion 一千亿美金 hundred billion 一千亿
那你看哦现在已经经过十年了
10 years have passed
还没有恢复哦
they have not they have not been restored to its original situation.
台湾的921大地震到现在已经经过满整整四年了。
Four years have passed since the great earthquake in Taiwan.
老百姓不是一直在骂政府吗？速度这么慢，我们都还没有加注啊。
And the people in Taiwan keep on blaming the government, saying that the houses have still not been built for them.
所以经过地震的破坏啊，就像核子战争一样哦。
So the destruction of an earthquake is just as great as that of an.
你们假如有机会去台湾哈，去台湾去访问，去看看这个地震破坏的情形呢，真是像核子战争一样。
If you have been to Taiwan or you have the chance to go there, you can know that the destruction caused by that great earthquake is just as great as that of an atomic bomb.
第六印哦，就是空前的大地震。
And so chapter 6 would be.The great earthquake that would strike the world.
就因为这样子，全世界都害怕了。
And so because of this, the whole world is frightful.
所以越来啊，灾难越大。
And so as history passes, the calamities to come would be even greater in destruction.
这个都还没有发生。
And all these things have not happened.
这个都是在一期之半。
And all these are in the first half of the final
7 weeks. 在最后的三年半。
In the final 7.5 weeks.Three and a half
所要发生的大事了。
The major events that would happen.
所以啊，五六这两个印。
So the seal, fifth seal and sixth seal.
我们呢、啊， 应该有机会哈，年轻的人应该有机会去遭遇的。
The younger Moses, perhaps will have the chance to encounter these happenings.
因为主耶稣什么时候来，我们不知道。
Because we do not know when Jesus is going to come.
所以以前呢、啊，黄长老他说哦，他很害怕，他不死的，他很怕死。
Elder Elisha Huang says, he was very afraid of death.
因为他是有钱人。
Because he was a wealthy, a rich man.He did not want to die. He hoped that he can live until the second coming of the Lord and he be changed alive and taken up to heaven.
可是你如果要主耶稣来升天，一定要通过大患难。
But then to reach that day, you must go through the great calamity.
要被人抓去打骂，
You will be taken captive, scolded.Beaten and be killed.
Oh, 他说这个更怕。
He says that is even more frightful.
死我不要。
He says I do not want to die.
啊，杀大逼迫我更怕。
I'm afraid of the great persecution.
哎呀，我真是两难啊。
He says I'm now in two difficulties.
所以主耶稣还是让他先走了。
So the Lord allowed him to go first.
因为那个皮肤太美了。
Because he was so ruddy.
这一逼迫不得了哎。
And if persecution were to come upon him, he would not be able to endure.
所以哦，一想到将来那个日子啊
，So when you think of that day to come,
路加福音二十一章，主耶稣说，吓得魂不附体呀。
And Luke chapter 21 says that many people will tremble.
真的哦，不想。
And truly, if you don't think about it, you will not be afraid.
越想越怕。
The more you think about it, the more you are afraid.
你看看我们现在的小朋友这么的受呵护。
You look at the young.Children, how we protect them.
一点点苦都不让他吃。
You do not even allow them a little bit of suffering.
将来遇到这个大麻烦了、大灾难怎么办？
What will happen when they meet with the great persecution?
所以想到我们就真的很担心了。
When you think about it, you will be very anxious.
但是在主里面有平安呢。
But in the Lord we have peace.
所以一定要带他们到主里面来。
So we must quickly bring them into the Lord.
因为到第九章啊、第七章都开始盖印了。第七章啊。
Because chapter 7 would be the time when the seal is stamped.
然后。第九章就开始伤害额上没有神印记的人。
And chapter 9 would be a time when harm would come upon those without the seal of God on their foreheads.
所以虽然是可
although it is so frightening,
但是主耶稣答应了，在我里你们有平安。
But then the Lord Jesus promises that in Him there is peace.
所以大家要好好的灵修。
So we must cultivate ourselves in spiritual nurture.
保守在走在主中。
Ourselves in the grace of Christ.
好，那么我们今天。到此结束、
I will end today's lesson here.
还有一点时间，有没有问题要发问？
Do you have any question to ask?
没有，我们再唱。
We are singing a hymn.
好，81首。
Eight. Great day of the Lord.
这一首唱起来很可怕的。
When you sing.